Now, you're all right. You've got your thing ready. Okay, we're going to go from the world of diversity to Brazil, from favelas to venture capital. Please welcome, it's a long name, Cristian Pinto Marinho. Marinho.
You don't. Now we're going to work together.
Yeah, we're going to work something.
Yeah, so imagine there's a virtual clicker and we're working with Sophie. So we can put the first one. So my name is Christian, as you saw, and then just over 2 years ago, I was a construction worker. And you might be thinking, is this guy lost? What is he doing here? This is not a construction event, right? So although I almost got lost in the metro station this morning, Châtelet is a piece of work, oh my God, but I'm not at the wrong event. I am at the right event, and but I'm going to tell you first where I come from. So I come from a place called Baixada Fluminense in the outskirts of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. My mom comes from a simple neighborhood called Complexo da Mangueirinha, or Favela da Mangueirinha. And my dad grew up as a street vendor alongside of his family that immigrated from Portugal to Brazil, looking for a better life, selling fruits and vegetables. And although my parents taught me many great lessons and worked really hard, the best lesson that they ever taught me was that I should dream as big as I possibly could. There was only one problem, though. In the public school system in Brazil, there's only three careers that one might realistically dream for achieving financial success. You can either be a really good athlete and become professional, you can become a famous pop artist, or you can simply join the local drug cartel, or let's put it, informal activities. For two of them, you need to be an outlier. And for the other one, well, we really don't want to go there. So, and then, although I was faced with that reality, I always had one dream. I knew that I was going to be really, really successful so I could give all not only the motivation, but also the support and the tools for poor kids from poor communities to be able to dream of becoming the next great poets, the next great politicians, scientists, or even a venture capitalist. So I got my paper, drew down what I knew was possible. Informal activities, no. I decided to save my singing skills for my shower concerts, and I decided to move on to becoming an athlete. Not satisfied with choosing one of the hardest professions to achieve, I ignored the fact that I grew up playing football as a good Brazilian, and chose my true passion. So I went to my parents. So hey, just informing you guys, I'm gonna become a professional American football player. You should have seen their faces. It was honestly, but it was their fault. They taught me to dream big, no? So I started brainstorming, how can you do it? First of all, you need to speak English, right? To play American football in the States. I didn't know a single word of English, and neither did my family or anyone in my close circle. Then you need to know some coaches, which I also didn't. You need to know how to play the sport, which I never played a single down of American football. And lastly, you need money, as living abroad is quite expensive. What happened was that since I had none of them, I needed to get to work. And I emailed not 10, not 30, not 100, but 200 coaches. And I got one crazy but visionary guy that took a shot. Thank you, Coach Ress. I hope I made you proud. And since I had my ass, I needed to make things happen. So now I just needed to learn a language from scratch at 17 years old, learn how to play a sport that I never practiced before, and also make some bucks. I started my own company. I learned how to cook some sweets and then hit the streets selling bus stops, stoplights, offices, and beauty salons, which surprisingly was where I found my product market fit. And then, although it was challenging, at 17 years old, I was one of the first Brazilians to ever play college American football, and later on went on to become a professional. And again, you might be wondering, what is he saying here, right? The thing is, I wish I was a huge success as a player, and then I was talking about my success as an athlete, or a golden medalist, but no, I failed miserably. The problem is, although I refused to get outworked by anyone, my body could not take the pounding of playing a sport that I never practiced before. And after many serious injuries, including playing my last season with a fractured leg, I decided to make the hardest decision I've ever made. So I quit the how that I loved so much in order to achieve my why, which was giving the next generation of kids the chance to dream. So I went back to my paper. And the beauty of having the chance to live abroad is that now, can you move to the next one? I could dream bigger. I saw that I was capable of doing more things. So after receiving an offer, I became a coach. Again, no network, no experience, and very little financial means, as I had to work as an Uber driver on the side to make the accounts balance. But I made it. I became one of the youngest offensive coordinators in Brazil. And after coaching 35 athletes for a couple of months, I received an opportunity to become a coach assistant in the United States. But in the middle, I saw a speech of a social entrepreneur, a guy that came from a favela in Brazil named Edu Lira, and went on to become the CEO of one of the largest NGOs in Brazil. And that guy, he was just like me. He came from the same background, and he achieved great things, and he was at Harvard speaking about how business could work alongside society to make the whole world a more inclusive and a more diverse place. And then when I saw him, when I felt connected to someone, I decided to add another item to my list. So I Googled, and I found out that venture capital allowed you to invest into the next great founders that would want to scale impactful global business. And so you know what? That sounds pretty cool, and that really fits with my why. So I just got to do it all over again, no? So no network, no previous experience, no money. And honestly, I didn't even know how to start. So I got to work. First of all, landed a scholarship in a good business school. I went to work, so can you move on to the next? So I got into construction and also tried my luck with babysitting. And that was not the hardest part. Because after I managed to get the money, I started applying for entry-level roles because I needed to learn, right? And how do you learn? You get an entry-level role. But then I figured out that although I had many skills that the job description said, like working in a fast-paced environment, being a good team player, having good interpersonal skills, and knowing how to build a community, after 60 applications, both in Europe and in Brazil, I got, zero interviews. So I got zero chances of even telling my story, even telling why I deserved a shot. And when I thought about giving up, I remember, no, I just need one shot. One shot, and then there was something magical happened, which was Included VC, a global, fully funded fellowship, thanks to Notion and daphni here, that allowed me, and then that created this bridge between the underrepresented talent and the closed circle of VC. And after having incredible mentorships with great investors like Pim that's present here, and finding out what type of investor that I wanted to become, I can say that today, the 5th of December of 2022, a former athlete, a former coach, a former Uber driver, a former babysitter, and a former construction worker went on to become a venture capital investor. And the best part is only just the beginning. So I want to leave you guys with one last message, okay? So we have a huge problem. Our youth is underserved and underinspired. We have a lack of relatable role models, and the excluding requirements for entry-level jobs are keeping incredible talent that could go on to become the next entrepreneurs and the next investors away from our industry. And we got to change that. And we, as an industry, we keep looking for markets with inefficiency that can be disrupted. And we ignored under our own eyes the amount of value that we waste. And then this needs to change now. Okay? So when you invest or when you hire underrepresented talent, you create a bridge that generates inclusion and generates extraordinary value, not only from a societal standpoint, but also with a financial standpoint. And although, yes, this is not a construction event, I want to invite all of you today in this industry to build those bridges together. And I think we can do it, honestly. And just one last thing, mom and dad, we made it. Thank you so much.